سيدي.
بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. In Arabic grammar, we say المعرف لا يعرف. What is already being known does not need to be known because it is already known. I will ask to introduce Sheikh Hatem to you, or to introduce you to Sheikh Hatem. I don't think anything or anyone in this city, to me, I consider two people, alhamdulillah. Leading mean khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allama. We have a lady, Ismail, in this city, and we have brother Hatem, and we know that what they are producing. I think this is the best introduction for me. But anyway, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. What will come out from him tonight, remember, it is not what we hear will keep us firm and strong, but it is what we do from what we hear. Speed is a motivation, but not a goal. The goal is when we do the speech, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُوعَدُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا. If you want the best in this dunya, and you want to be very firm and strong, do what you are told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the only source of power. So we are here tonight to share that, inshallah. And I cannot introduce Sheikh Hatem to you, because he is known, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep him in this city for eternity, if I'm allowed to say so. But no one is eternal. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who hear and follow the best from what they have heard. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi. Jazakum Allah khair, Sayyidina. Jazakum Allah khair, Sheikh Adam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your words. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللهم اغفر لنا ما لا يعلمون. اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك صفاتك أن تغفر لنا الذلل، ونسألك بأسمائك صفاتك أن ترزقنا يا رب العالمين أن نكون خيرا مما يظنون. جزاك الله خير شيخ آدم for all these words. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to follow your steps in this life, your wisdom, your wise words, and we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى, as you are trying to unite the community and we are trying to follow your steps in this, and all of us, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his message, and to continue in this life, our life, all life, our life, to continue inshallah to the end of our life reciting the Quran, teaching the Quran, learning the Quran and the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair, Sheikh Adam, and jazallah khairan all brothers and sisters. They are organizing these talks, and also I would like to thank all brothers and sisters they are attending today to inshallah sharing the knowledge of the Quran and knowledge of Islam. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala ashraf khalqillah Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa ihtada bihadihi wa sana bi sunnati wa ihtada atharahu al-qawim wa al-din. Amma ba'd, my dear brothers and sisters, طبتم وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة مقعدا إن شاء الله، ورزقنا الله وإياكم الجنة، وجعلنا الله وإياكم من أهل الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Today I came today with intention to remind myself and remind everyone about how we can haste and how we can race, how we can compete each other in asking Allah forgiveness and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his paradise. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ala inna sil'at Allah ghaliyah, ala inna sil'at Allah al-jannah. Sil'at Allah, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us for being a good slave to him, It's the paradise. And this paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described this paradise with مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وُعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The similar of al-jannah and the example of al-jannah as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for those who are al-muttaqoon, for those who are righteous, for those who are working hard on this earth to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for those who are working hard to make a good a'mal and to be a good person or good man or good woman or good wife or good husband or good student or good youth or good imam or good husband. Al-Jannah prepared for al-muttaqeen, for the righteous. مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وُعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ فِيهَا جَنَّاتٌ فِيهَا أَنْهَارٌ مِنْ مَاءٍ غَيْرِ آسٍ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about al-Jannah as there is rivers inside. Today we are coming to talk about hasten towards the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His paradise. And we are inspired by the ayah in al-Qur'an. Ayah in al-Qur'an in Surah Al-Imran, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ. سَارِعُوا. Al-Musara'ah, when we are talking about al-Musara'ah, in Arabic words, we are talking about how to raise yourself or compete yourself. But when we are talking about al-Musabaqah, سَابِقُوا, in the ayah that I recited in al-Isha, سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم, in another ayah in Surah Al-Hadid, we are talking about the competing each other. So the Quran talked about how to raise yourself, how to hasten yourself in asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness, how to develop yourself in this, how to improve the quality of your iman, of your faith, how to improve the quality of the ibadah, how to improve your quality in your relationships with everyone, to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is encouraging us in this ayah for asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness. And the Prophet Muhammad, my dear brothers and sisters, used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one sitting between 70 to 100 times in different hadith. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. When he was sitting with his companions. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. And in this materialistic life nowadays, we are working very hard to gain materialism around us. We are working hard to deal with everyone day and night, and we are thinking day and night about many things except the main thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for His ibadah, for His worship. Because of this, we have in our days shortcomings in to fulfill what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need us to do. Yani we have problem. You are waking up, you are not thinking of what you have done last night in your ibadah. For example, you are not thinking of Qiyam al-Layl. Some of us, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah, they are praying whole night. And some of us, they are praying at night. Some of us, they are not leaving al-Witr. They are praying al-Witr. Some of us, they are raising themselves and hastening themselves with praying Qiyam al-Layl. Some of us, they are waking up thinking about Salat al-Fajr, and some of us, they are skipping Salat al-Fajr. Because of this, in fulfilling our ibadah, we need to ask Allah forgiveness for our shortcomings, even in the ibadah itself. As we used to say, what is the first thing we are saying after Salah? After we finish, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, assalamu alaikum wa barakatuh. What is that? Huh? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Why? To fulfill what that we did in our salah. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us in this ayah, sari'u, hasten toward the forgiveness and seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is for you. This is for you to protect yourself. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, sabiqu ila maghfiratin, compete one another. Compete one another. For what? For ask Allah forgiveness. And this mentioned in different ayat in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. For this sake, for al-ibadah, for the Jannah, after the ayat of إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ تَعْرِفُ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ نَضْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ خِتَامُهُ مِسْكٍ وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. For the sake of al-Jannah, for only one target, my target on this life to enter al-Jannah. After I live in this life, whatever I will live, 70 years, 100 years, 1,000 years as the Prophet Nuh, you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your target must focus to enter His paradise subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. This is المنافسة, the competition. So if you ask anyone of the boys now, what you would like to compete in the games? For the elders, what you are thinking to compete, huh? For the materialism, you will find a lot of people, they are talking about how much I take in my income, how much. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us in the Quran, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ. Your risk on the sky, your provision in the sky, don't think about it. Don't think about it. نحن لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this to everyone. But don't think a lot. Don't make your mind focus on this life about the materialism. Think only about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. سارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم. Race and hasten toward the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the paradise. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا. For the paradise. What is the Jannah? What is the description of this Jannah in this ayah? Because if you would like to know Jannah very well, so you have to take the Quran and whole Quran as a one line and to explain each ayah mentioned in the Quran about the Jannah. If you would like to know about the Muttaqeen, so you have to go and read whole the Quran to know what those who are righteous. But now we are talking about this ayah. سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Or this in Qalun, we skip the waw. But in Hafs, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ. This Jannah, this paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for us, for al-muttaqeen, for the righteous, for those who are worshiping Him, for those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who are working hard to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who comes to the mosque, for those who are donating, for those who are love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly from their hearts, for those who would like to continue in this life to just pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who are stopping their tongue from backbiting, for those who are close their ears from hearing the haram, for those who are closing their eyes from looking to haram, from those who are stopping their hands from taking haram, from those who are not for those who are stopping their leg or their feet to walk toward any haram. Jannah, arduha, as-samawat wal-ard. The width of this Jannah, of this paradise, exactly as between the heavens and the earth. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ Prepared for who? Prepared for those who are righteous. Who's المُتَّقِينَ يَا رَبَّ? Who's المُتَّقُونَ يَا رَبَّ? What is the definition of المُتَّقِينَ if you'd like to be among them, my dear brothers and sisters? المُتَّقِينَ مين المُتَّقِينَ? Who المُتَّقِينَ? Huh? The definition comes in the ayah after this ayah. الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. So this Jannah, this paradise, prepared for who? For المتقين. For who? For المتقين. For righteous. الذين. What is the definition? Who المتقين? Who المتقون? How to be among those who are المتقين? So if he will fulfill, inshallah, these criteria. Those criteria. Follow with me and read with me. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ Those who are donating. If you'd like to be among those who will enter Jannah, inshallah. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ Those who are donating when they have, when they are not having. When they have thousands, millions in their bank account, when they have nothing in their bank account, when they have only $1. They are making donations. They are not thinking a lot when they are paying something for the sake of Allah. Or buying something for the sake of Allah, or doing something for the sake of Allah. When they are giving qad hasan, when they are helping some poor people, when they are helping to open water, to make water for their brothers and sisters in any developing countries, when they are sending any helping to any of brothers and sisters in anywhere, when they are helping people, they are not thinking. يَذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ They are making donation. They are making sadaqah. And they understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah At-Tawbah, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً Take from them the sadaqah, from the donation. And the benefits for you, my dear brothers and sisters. The benefits, it's for you. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا Allah will not take from the aqiqah or from the slaughters that you will make it for the sake of Allah, Allah will not the blood or the flesh or the body of what you will slaughter for the sake of Allah. So the donation, it will be for you. For what? As purification to your heart, as purification from the sin. خذ من أموالهم صدقة تطهرهم وتزكيهم. Because of this, my dear brothers and sisters, al-infaq fi sabilillah fi halat al-ghina wa fi halat al-faqr. Al-ladhina yunfiquna fi s-sarra'i wa-d-dara'a. Those who are donating for the sake of Allah when they have, when they are not having, my dear brothers and sisters. Those people among the best people, the beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, دوس المتقين عباد الله عباد الرحمن الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء when they have difficulties they are donating when they have and my dear brothers and sisters I'm talking about this point because the majority of us when we don't have anything when we don't have for example job we start to think if I have job if I have good income When I have income, I will make this donation for the sake of Allah. Yes, this is difficult time for me, but when I will have, I will give. But when, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the gate to them, and they start to have a good income, they start to have shuh and bukh. They afraid to make even donation every month or every week with $10. They start to think about every dollar they will pay it for the sake of Allah. Why? Because this is the heart of the people. This is the heart of the humans. This is the heart of the humans when they doesn't have, when they don't have, they are thinking in this way. But for those who are promising Allah, when they will have, they will pay and they will donate, but when they have, When Allah opened to them and gave it to them good life and good wealth, they stop. Remember this ayah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهَ لَإِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ Some of them, the munafiqeen, some of them, the hypocritical people, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they asking Allah, oh Allah, give me, oh Allah, then they give Allah promise. Oh Allah, make it easy for me. If I will have this amount of money, I will donate for the sake of you. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهَ لَإِنْ أَتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ When Allah give us from His wealth, from His ghina subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَأَصَّدَّقَانَ I will make donation. Then, فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give to them a good wealth, good income, بَخِلُوا بِهِ They stop to give. They stop to give anything. So, one of the main criteria to be among al-muttaqeen, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared al-jannah to them, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared the paradise that is the width, it's between the heaven and the earth, this is the first criteria. When you will have, inshallah, when you don't have, so my dear brothers and sisters, you have to make donations. And because nowadays we have many things make our mind busy. So you can assign your bank account and send regular to any organization. Like if even $10, if you have intention to like take a good hasanat, you can make $1 every day or $10 every day or as much as you can, as you love, to any organization that you are trust, you can make it as every day or every week to assign to donate to this organization, or you can send to someone and someone will distribute it to you, or you can make it by your hand every day or every week or every month. If you will do something like that, you will be among those who are al-munfiqeen, those who will be inshallah enter al-jannah from the door of al-infaq fi sabilillah. Okay, so this is the practical things that we can take from this lecture, my dear brothers and sisters. الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the second criteria to be among those who will enter the Jannah, inshallah. What is the next? الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء وإيه؟ والكاظمين الغيظ. Those who are controlling their anger. Those who are, mashallah, can control their anger. When someone attack them, when someone make jahala on them, when someone from ignorant people, they attack them, they are not start shouting and screaming and they are trying jumping and they are very quiet. Especially when they have power, when you are strong, when you are in position, you can destroy this person. And you have this power and you are controlling your anger. If you are one of those people, you will be among those who will enter the Jannah, inshallah. والكاظمين الغيظ. Those who have all power to take their rights. When someone from the ignorant people or from jahileen to do this to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned clearly in the Quran, those who are الكاظمين الغيظ, they control their anger. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my dear brothers, one of the Sahaba came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him, "O Prophet, awsini, give me advice, recommend something to me to make me enter Jannah." Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him this word: "Control your anger, لا تغضب." Control your anger. That's it. Awsini, give me advice. So when you feel that you have blooded, don't say, "Alhamdulillah, I have, يعني, too much." يعني power to I can attack and respond to anyone. Like, this is one of the criteria to be among those who are muttaqeen. If you can control your anger, if you can stop your tongue when you are in fighting, you are stopping your tongue. You can say if words and bad words and everything, but you can stop it. You can stop your tongue. You can control your tongue. Your tongue. If you are among those who can control their tongue. They can control their body. They can control their eyes when they are looking to people with anger face or anger anger way, and you stop yourself from doing this, you are among those who are al-muttaqeen, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, u'iddat lil-muttaqeen, alladhina yunfiquna fi sarra wal-dharra wal-kadhimina al-ghayd. Then, wal-'afina 'anil nas. What the meaning of al-'afina 'anil nas? Those who special people. Those عافين عن الناس, they seek pardon to everyone around them. Seek pardon, forgive people. They have this heart. Those people, if you are one of them, my dear brothers, if you have this soft heart to forgive people, you have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to say alhamdulillah. I met some people, they are saying, well, I can't forgive this person. I can't. For what? For nothing. Maybe they was like argue together in something very small. I can't forgive him. Why? So you will not be among those who are not, you will not be among those who are muttaqeen. The Quran is teaching us. If someone even steal your money and he came to me and asked you forgiveness and you still have your right with him and you would like to take your rights back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. If someone do something wrong to you, you can take your rights from him. But then in Surah Al-Shura, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. For those who will forgive, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is control this reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responsible about giving the reward to the one who will forgive. So if you have anything in your heart toward anyone, this among those who are hasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about those who are hasting and racing and competing one another and competing themselves to ask Allah forgiveness with this way. Seek forgiveness to others and forgive others and control your heart when you are dealing with people. This is just difficult way, this is the difficult thing in your life when you are dealing with people. The relationships is not easy. It's not easy to someone take your rights and you forgive. It's not easy, believe me. If you have any problem with any one of your relatives, if you are sitting before you sleep and say, oh, this person, Muhammad, I have trouble with him, I forgive him. I forgive this woman, she was doing this to me. I forgive my dad, he did this to me. I will call my dad, maybe I have a clash with my dad, I will forgive him. I will call him, Assalamu alaikum, my dad. I forgive you if you are, please forgive me if I do. These start, they are humble. This ibadur rahman, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. One of the criteria of Ibad al-Rahman, those who are the best people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Forgive people. They are saying salama to those who are ignorant. They are attacking them and saying, salama, salama, assalamu alaikum. Forgive people. So when you are forgiving people, you are among those who are al-muttaqeen, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love the door people. Those who are believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As in the hadith, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, the hadith Jibreel alayhi salam, when Jibreel alayhi salam came to teach the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and he said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam and teach him, asking him about Islam, what is Islam. Then he said to him, yes, you are saying the truth. What is Iman and what is Ihsan? Do you remember this hadith? What is Ihsan? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what respond to him? To the Prophet, to Angel Jibreel, Al-Ihsan, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. To believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you feel in your heart, as you always put in your mind that Allah exists around me, is watching me. When you are closing your door, you are stopping doing any haram. You are not watching any haram. You are not eating any haram. You are not doing any haram. You are not stealing anything. You are with Allah. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. As you can see him. As you can see him. You can imagine if you are Allah and if in front of you, you will do any mistakes? You will do any sin? You will never do anything. You will be the best. If you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this way, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. But if you will not see him on this earth, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see his face inshallah in the Jannah. If you could not see him, but he could see you. He are seeing you. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this way, my dear brothers and sisters, if you feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you, if you are seeing that, feeling that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's watching you all the time, and you feel that you are watching him, you are seeing him, you will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any sins, committing any sins. And you will have muraqabah to yourself. This is called al-ihsan, to be among al-muhsineen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah loves those who are al-muhsineen. So if you feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you and you are watching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything in your life, you are among those who Allah loves. Allah loves you. Wallahu yuhibbu al-muhsineen. And al-ihsan also to forgive, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the surah A, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنْ النَّاسِ. This is also the criteria and definition of al-ihsan. So, الَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنْ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. This from al-ihsan. When you are doing all these criteria, so from al-ihsan al-muttaqeen. So if you'd like to get the whole definition of al-ihsan or whole definition of al-muttaqeen, you can read all the ayat that mention al-muttaqeen and al-ihsan al-Qur'an. You will understand this more and more. But today we are talking about al-musabaqa and al-musara'a. If you are hastening, my dear brothers and sisters, remember that al-musabaqa is one of the important, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was praying whole night, and Aisha radiallahu anha asked him, O Prophet, you are the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your previous sin and all coming sin. مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكُمْ وَتَأَخَّرَ. And you are praying whole night. Why? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he respond? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Shall I not be a grateful servant? Shall I not be a good servant or thankful servant, grateful servant? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. So my dear brothers, if you will say, I don't have time to worship Allah, if you will say, I don't have time to ask Allah forgiveness, if you will say, I don't have time to make infaq fi sabilillah, if you will say, this will put you in category to enter al-Jannah with difficulties. But those who would like to enter al-Jannah with the prophets, with the salihin, with al-munfiqeen, with al-muslimin, with al-mustaghfirin, with those who will enter al-Jannah from all the doors, as Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Umar al-Khattab, they used to hasten in this. They used to compete one another in this. Umar al-Khattab and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. You know the hadith that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asked for the donation. And Umar ibn Khattab, he said, today I will compete, inshallah, Abu Bakr. Today, the best time for me to compete Abu Bakr. Today, that the time I will show the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that I am better than Abu Bakr. They are thinking in this way. Those people, the best people after prophets. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Umar al-Khattab, the best humans after prophets. Allah chose them to protect his religion. Allah chose them. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace and blessing be upon him, asked for donation, what Abu Bakr as-Siddiq he did? What Umar al-Khattab he did? Abu Bakr, Umar al-Khattab, he said, today I will bring half my wealth. All that I will count how many I have in my hadiqa, in my gardens, in my horse, in my everything. I will bring the half of my wealth. It's too much. Yeah, and you can imagine if you have like 1 million, alhamdulillah, in the bank account, and we are yani hastened toward something, you are competing one another for the sake of Allah, and you say, today I will donate with 500,000. Maybe you will go to the hospital direct after. Umar al-Khattab, he think in this way, today I will raise Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and I will compete him inshallah. For the sake of Allah, not for the dunya. For the sake of Allah, for the akhirah, for Jannah. They are thinking in this way, al-Jannah. I don't have any intention except al-Jannah. I see al-Jannah. I see only al-Jannah. This is my intention. I would like to spend all my time, all my life, all my wealth, all for my kids, everything, because of al-Jannah. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, what he did? He brought all his money, all his wealth. What he have? He brought everything. When Umar ibn al-Khattab, he came and he gave to the Prophet Muhammad the half of his wealth, Prophet Muhammad asked him, what did you leave to your family? He said, alhamdulillah, I left half of them. And he was happy, you know, standing beside the Prophet Muhammad, I left half of them. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, when he came with all his wealth, what did you leave to your family? I left for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them. Allah will give them. I didn't leave to them anything. You didn't leave to them anything? Umar al-Khattab, he was asking, la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. I will not compete Abu Bakr anymore. He said this, I will not compete Abu Bakr anymore. Khalas. This is a way that the Sahaba, they used to do. When someone from the Sahaba, or from the tabi'een, from the scholar, they doesn't pray. One day, al-Fajr, they went to the... One day, Jazakumullah khair, Sayyidina. When they forget, or maybe the time of al-Fajr came and they didn't pray al-Fajr, the tabi'een and ulama and mashayikh, they used to go to this sheikh and make aza'. Inna lillahi wa inna, they are saying to him, inna lillahi wa inna raji'un, for only one day, for al-fajr. How many fajr you left this month? They used to talk about al-qiyam al-layl, the night pray every day. They used to talk about how many hadith you read, how many juz you read, how many juz. If I ask you, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the competition that we have here now. How many pages, how many juz you memorize today? We have to ask ourselves about this. If you are not reading the Quran now, when you will read the Quran? You have gold in your hand. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, if you will read one letter, you will take 10 hasana. Wallahu yudha'if liman yasha'. If you memorize Surah Al-Baqarah and Al-Imran, it will come as a protection to you from the hellfire. If you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and at the night, the Azkar al-Sabah and al-Masa', when you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this way, you will get more benefits. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وله كل شيء قدير. See the benefits of what you will take. So the Sahaba, they used to compete one another in this. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, my dear brothers and sisters, he said, بادروا بالأعمال سبعة. Compete one another in seven things. Before, هل تنتظرون إلا فقرا منسيا? And he's asking us and like blaming us. The question, blaming us. Are you waiting until your income or your money stopped? Until the poverty control you? Are you waiting? Are you waiting to donate until the poverty control you and make you and you are poor? أو غنى مدغية, when you have too much money and you forget to donate? Why you are waiting? Why you are waiting? Or to get too much old and you don't have control in your mind? Is asking us, this Prophet Muhammad is asking us, are you are waiting until you get old and you can't pray when you are standing? We will reach to this level. We all will reach to this age. Are you are waiting? So if you are not praying the sunnah, if you are not praying the nafila, if you are not fasting, if you are not fasting Monday and Thursday, if you are not donating, if you are not, are you are waiting until you get old and you don't have any control in your mind? Or are waiting the death that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for everyone? This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Or are waiting until Dajjal is come? Or you are waiting until the hour will come, Sa'ah? What we are waiting? So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is asking us, encouraging us in this hadith, don't wait until you lose everything. You will be among the losers. But if you will take this chance, my dear brothers and sisters, and start from now praying, don't. Are you are waiting until you get very old and wear hijab for the sisters? So remember, the hijab is faridah. If you are saying, I'm still young, I'm still 18 years old, 20s, I'm still, mashallah, the beautiful, alhamdulillah, I'm beautiful, mashallah, I have to wait until, like, feel the hijab after 30 or 40 or 50 or 60. So don't wait. Don't wait. Because the death comes like this. So this is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ways. My dear brothers and sisters, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said that when we will die, everything will leave us. When we die, the janazah, three things will follow us. The family, your family, and your wealth, and your deeds. Your family, and your wealth, and your deeds. Your family and your wealth will come back. People, they will take your family will take your wealth, or the government. Huh? And your family will go and they will live normal. As this, subhanAllah, this is a nature, this is a fitrah. The life is continue. Huh? Life is continue. And only one thing will continue with you in your grave. Your a'mal, your deeds. So there are many ways of increasing your a'mal. There are many ways. I will finish this, inshallah, lecture with this way, my dear brothers and sisters. So the best way to increase your a'mal, dhikr Allah, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to increase your a'mal, my dear brothers and sisters, to make qada hawa'ij al-muslimin. يعني to increase your a'mal, the best way, dhikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best dhikr, reading the Qur'an. And the best dhikr, to be busy with the Qur'an. To read the Qur'an, understand the Qur'an, try to act like the Qur'an, to have the behavior of the Qur'an, to be like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Aisha radiallahu anha, when she was asked about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam behavior and moral, she was saying, he exactly like the Qur'an. So if you'd like to be like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, read the Qur'an and make tadabbur to the Qur'an, understand the Qur'an, feel the Qur'an in your heart. So this is the best way to gain hasanat and to be the best in your moral, in your akhlaq, and everything. Huh? Dhikr Allah Azza Jal. And you have many things in your day. So you can increase your dhikr with La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulku wa lahu al-hamdu wa ala kulli shay'in qadir. You can stay after al-fajr and say, Allahumma ma asbaha bi min ni'matin aw bi ahadin min khuluqik. Fa minka wahdaka la sharika lak. فلك الحمد ولك الشكر. You can say بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء ولا في الأرض. You can say the سيد الاغفار الاستغفار the best sayings in الاستغفار. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت، أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت، أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي، فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. يعني you ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى forgiveness with this hadith. This is the best one. If you'd like to memorize it, go and memorize it. اللهم أنت ربي. This is the سيد الاستغفار. The master of all ahadith or all sayings of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to ask Allah forgiveness. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك. Repeat after me. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت، أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت، أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي، فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت، فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب. أو أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. Ask Allah forgiveness. As we said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say istighfar from 70 to 100 times in one sitting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Hud, he mentioned in Surah Hud, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِدْرَارًا وَيَزِدُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَى قُوَّتِكُمْ. The people of Aad, the people of Hud, the Qawm Hud, they are very strong. They are very tall and very strong. And when Hud alayhi salam came to them and told them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only one and worship him, they said to him, يعني, do you like us to follow only one God? How? We are very strong. We didn't need your God. We are very strong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them that if you will increase your istighfar, asking Allah forgiveness with your tongue, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you more with more rizq. يرسل السماء عليكم إدرارا ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم, and will increase your energy, you increase your health. So this is encouragement to everyone, my dear brothers and sisters. If you have sickness, or if you are ill, if you are weak and you feel weakness in your heart or weakness in your body, so just sit and with this intention, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen by your tongue. That's it. Just astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. You don't feel that you can't stand up with your leg, but in your mind that Allah will give me good health if I ask Allah forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in Quran. Yes, istighfar increase your energy, increase your health. Yes, so you will get benefits, and also the benefits will make you enter al-Jannah, as we started with sari'u ila maghfirah min rabbikum wa jannah. So this balance, how to live in this life with this balance, to enjoy your life and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the words that he sent it to us through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the strengthen, and also to have this balance with enter al-Jannah at the end inshallah. So my dear brothers and sisters, these two things, making ibadat, increase your ibadat, and make it easy to the people. Qada hawa'ij al-Muslimin. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, khayru an-nasi anfa'uhum lin-nas. The best of the people, those who are giving benefits to others. Those are the best. The best one who are giving benefits to the people. So if you are helping people with everything in your hand, if you're helping the community, if you are helping the kids, if you can't help people, you can donate for the sake of Allah. Helping with all different ways, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among those who will enter al-Jannah, my dear brothers and sisters. As I started with the ayat from وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم
ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون.
صدق الله العظيم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك صفاتك أن تغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع دعاء. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع دعاء. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وجلاء همومنا وأحزاننا. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك. اللهم اجعل حبك أحب إلينا من أنفسنا ومن أهلينا. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولمن لهم فضل علينا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم ارزقنا حج بيتك الحرام وزيارة مسجد نبينا عليه الصلاة والسلام. اللهم كما جمعتنا في هذه الدنيا على طاعتك نسألك بأسمائك صفاتك أن تجمعنا في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. اللهم اجمعنا في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. اللهم اجمعنا في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا. الله يخليك، جزاك الله خير. لكن الله يسرك، جزاك الله ان شاء الله. لكن
بارك الله فيك
حبيبي.
عايزين نتكرر
شيء، هي مش هتبقى مره واحده ان شاء الله.